In 2001, the NLP became the law in the United States, and so organic is a literal legal term. It's governed by the USDA. So strictly speaking, organic means nothing synthetic and no genetic modification. And so where most of American farming relies on synthetic fertilizer and pesticides, we cannot use any of those. And every input we have has to be considered natural, holistic, has to be on an approved list. We cannot have any genetic modification, which obviously most seeds in conventional agriculture are. For me personally, the key difference between organic and conventional, because I farmed both ways, is that conventional is very prescriptive. And for me personally, organic's been more of a holistic approach. I have been here, this is my 17th growing season, and honestly, I'm telling you, 20 years ago, I would have been like, Christine, that won't work, the things we're doing. But I have done it 17 years, I've lived it every day, and this way is so fulfilling to me. And it's been so rewarding. And what we are trying to do is maximize the microbiome of the soil. And this diversity, we have to have vitality in the soil itself. When the soil is alive and has its own life force, the food within it does too, and you can see it. And a person that's been trained in agronomy or crop science can take tissue tests, can take soil tests, can do visual assessments of the crop itself, and I could walk you to any of these fields, and we do not have micronutrient deficiencies. Our yields are keeping up with conventional yields. For many reasons, that way I know it's working. I think the key is balance. What's fascinating is when you really look at the life of the soil, you have to look at the life of the plant too. So how can the plant be more wholesome or nutritious than the soil it's grown in? It's impossible. So if you have an empty soil, you're going to have an empty plant nutritionally also. There's only one place the plant can grab its nutrition. It has to come from the dirt. And 40% of a plant's photosynthesis energy is put back down into the roots, which is kind of cool. And there's this beautiful symbiotic relationship in the soil between the fungus and the mycorrhizal highways and the bacteria and the roots itself. And I think if you have balance and the plant has vitality and the soil has vitality, then they're able to utilize the micronutrients in a more balanced way. I think the important thing is that when your soil has balance, then the plant is able to utilize every micronutrient it needs. Because the micronutrient that is the least available is going to be your limiting factor in yield and nutrition and everything. And so a balanced soil is your best bet.